Right, Densill Theobald, Densill Bleeder Theobald, former national player, 2006 World Cup hero, played in all three matches for Trinidad and Tobago. Now you've begun to transition your career. You're operating in a different capacity, imparting your knowledge and experience to the youth of Trinidad and Tobago, the U15 TTFA High Performance Program. How has that been going for you?
It's been going great. You know, it's always a pleasure to serve the country, especially in the capacity of football. And more so for myself, a young, aspiring, ambitious coach, you know, it's a joy. It's something I relish, you know, and I'm grateful at the same time the TTFA gave me this opportunity to work with the under 15 boys that started last year under 14 level.
Tell us about this high performance program. We've been hearing a lot about it. We know it's supposed to be the top 40 or 45 U15 boys in the country that have been working under people like yourself and Paul Deckel, who is the coordinator for the high performance program, Johan C. Marshall, who's one of your assistants now. What happens in this high performance program?
Well, the high performance is based on developing, most important, it's not a team, right? It started last year, the under 14 level, and it's a 3-year program, right, that will lead up to the national under 17 team that will prepare for the World Cup qualifiers. And it's just an opportunity where we started the screening process at under 14 level, and we have narrowed that down to the best 40 players, as you identified, right, to be part of the program that will be coached at the highest level, trying to develop that elite mentality in the young boys, right, and also to continue, you know, that program that was never in place until, you know, the TD, Anton Cornell, you know, saw the initiative, you know, to start going back to programs that identify with developing talent, being together and being able to nurture that talent, so when we reach the under 17 level and under 20, so that we will basically have a team that is able to compete and be competitive at the CONCACAF level, which we strive for, right? I think it's a great initiative. I think it's a great program because it serves the youngsters well. When they come here, they know they are properly coached. They know it's about their development as a player, right? So the onus is on them, you know, to take that responsibility, what they learn here, and try to incorporate it in their lives. It's not about football only with us, but also to create young men, create role models for society. Right, so with all that being said, I think that it's a program that it is here to last, right, based on, you know, the TTFA implementing this and also with the help of the TD2 as well.
You have these boys for what, 2 days a week? Tell us, what are some of the aspects of the game that you focus on, and is 2 days a week it's sufficient at this point in time?
Well, we started 3 days per week, but because of players' various club commitments on the weekend with their respective clubs, you know, makes it difficult for us to include that third session. But in saying that, when they come here, they know they are developing technically, tactically, mentally, which is most important, and also physically. Right, so we always try to incorporate those four aspects, you know, of their development, which is important for them. And I believe that when they continue to apply what is being learned here, they have a bright future ahead of them in the international realm.
Coaches like yourself who've been put in charge of this program, what is the TTFA doing from the technical department, the coaching education program? Anton Cornell obviously oversees that. How do they prepare coaches like yourself to be the persons overseeing what you refer to as an elite program?
Well, basically, to be a coach in this program, you must be licensed minimum, right? Which Johansi myself is already part of, right? So that coaching education is very important. And of course, with the TD and with his help, with his experience, along with Paul Deckel, we continue to all work together, right? To form that, you know, that blueprint, right? That will enable, you know, the boys, as I say, to be competitive, to be able to learn, to grow, to develop. So when a player is part of our program, we expect when they go back to the respective club, they will be able to spot and see that difference in that set player. And that's important for us. But also at the same time, we as coaches, we continue to grow and develop. So as much as we have our B license, we always want to continue to learn and grow and progress. So we're looking at the A license, you know, hopefully before the year is done, early into the next year, to continue progressing, you know, in our young coaching career.
One of the reasons I asked specifically in terms of what does the TTFA do to prepare persons like yourself as coaches, what is unique about what we do here? Because obviously we know the B license and the A license is open to coaches from throughout the region. Just recently we had the Grenada coach in the B license. So it means that, you know, people are from around the region, our competitors, they now have access to this sort of information, this sort of training. What do you guys do now to ensure that what we're doing here is particular to Trinidad and Tobago, to obviously enhance our football, to compete against these countries and to take our football to another level?
Well, what you are saying is quite right, true, and it goes all over the world, because you see the football, the gap between big country and small countries narrowing now, right? Because of the information at everyone's disposal. And it's important we as coaches here, we continue to maintain that hunger, that desire, you know, to help with the aid of development for these players that belong to the program. And also for us to continue, you know, in that progress and that pathway of our coaching education, in our coaching philosophy as well. So it all goes hand in hand, but it all comes down to the hunger, that passion, that desire, willing to serve the country as we did as players, being able to transfer that now in their coaching capacity. That will augur well for the boys, because as much as they are young, they still don't know the history of Trinidad and Tobago football, and it's something we try to educate them on. Right, we try to help them with too as well, you know. So they come, they more or less come from scratch, and they must leave with something that, you know, be able to help them in their development.
You touched on something there which I want to bring up. Obviously, what is happening on the field of play here? What sort of classroom sessions or educating of players? What is the approach you all are taking to get them to understand what it means to play for country, you know, what this country has achieved in the past, the history of Trinidad and Tobago football? Are these part of the elements of the high performance program?
Yes, of course, it's important, because you look at it from a theory's perspective, right? Once the opportunity presents itself, there will be classroom too as well, where they will be educated on knowing the history of Trinidad and Tobago football. You know, when they come to the home of football, where we will be meeting in due time, you will be able to see our young players or young stars who qualified for the Under 17 World Cup, right? Who was able to do it, and they will be able to see our senior team. You know, they had the experience where we went to Tobago and experienced Trinidad senior team playing versus Nicaragua. So all these experiences we want to bring to their attention to lift their motivation, you know, to give them that passion, you know, to really want to wear that national color one day. So it's just raising the awareness, and that has to be done through the theory perspective, you know, taking them back to the classroom, having meeting, educating them also about, you know, the moments of the game, you know, educating them about, you know, their tasks, their basic tasks from the player position they play in their respective clubs. And also for here, it's just about education, Shawnee. And it's important for them, and it's important for us, that we continue, you know, to lay that foundation, set that foundation, so we know we can reap, you know, the rewards of foundations like these programs implemented in the near possible future, but more important, the longevity of Trinidad football.
Right. Densill, of course, obviously, it's an absolute pleasure speaking to you and to get an insight into your role in the development of Trinidad and Tobago players and the High Performance Program. Good luck to you.
Thank you, Shawnee.
We have just started a scan, guys. We have to start a scan. Look over your shoulder to see where your teammates are. You can know what to do with the ball before you get it. Come on, Keston, come on. That's what we was working on the passing drill for. For that same reason. Let me clean it up.
Live when he receives.
Yes, baby. No problem.
Right. Densill, obviously it's been 17 years since we qualified for the World Cup in Germany. You were an integral part of that team. You know, when you look back at history and where we are right now, how much are you inspired by what took place there in terms of, you know, what you impart onto the onto football in Trinidad?
I think it's all that matters, right? Success. Because you will be judged on success. You will be judged on results. And you know, to see our football is getting back to those glory days in due time, you know, it just augurs well for the future. And as I mentioned before, programs like these, it could only augur well for the young player, right, in his development, where before we didn't have programs like these. If you look back on the history of Trinidad football, the last time we had a program like this was under the stewardship and leadership of Mr. John Williams. May his soul rest in peace, right, through the elite program with, again, deceased Clyde Leon and also Stuart Charles Favre, right? So in saying that, programs like these is an impetus for the youth Sunday, in order to remain motivated that we are doing all that is possible within our capacity, within our resources, you know, to provide that opportunity for them to capitalize on that opportunity. Because as much as these are 40 young, aspiring young men who want to go on to represent their country one day, there are others on the sideline who want that same opportunity as them. So we always try to emphasize to them the importance of appreciating the opportunity, but working extremely hard and doing even the extra to maintain their stance, to maintain their personnel on the national program itself. So in order, the future augurs well for Trinidad football.
Right. When you look back at the 2006 campaign and your days as a player, what are some of the highlights, some of the things that stick to your head?
Well, what sticks to my head is me being a youngster, one of the younger players on that team, just looking and feeding on information from the Dennis Lawrence, Marvin Andrews, Dwight York, Russell Atapi. I remember spending so much time with Dwight in his room, or even when he returned, you know, just sourcing that information, what it took, you know, for him to be out there, what it took for him to achieve longevity in his career and also that success. So that for me was a highlight, besides of course us qualifying for the World Cup. You know, I thought it was a tremendous job that started with Bertil Sinclair and it was finished by Leo Beenhakker. I thought, you know, it was fantastic in terms of what Leo brought, you know, to the Trinidad football, the structure, the organization, the professionalism, the ambition. You know, all in all, it really was, in all the work of the Almighty God, bringing all this and making it possible for our country, that brought the joy, you know, brought that unison, brought that togetherness for our people of Trinidad and Tobago.
Final question, Densill. Any one of these former players, former coaches that were part of this campaign that you are in touch with, you know, who you bounce things off, who you get words of inspiration from?
Of course, I'm in constant contact with Dennis Lawrence, who feeds the necessary information for me to keep growing and developing as a young, aspiring, ambitious coach, right? I also talk with Leo Beenhakker from time to time, right? And I also talk a lot with the TD Anton Cornell, you know, who, with his wealth of knowledge and information at his disposal, you know, keeps me on that right pathway, keeps me focused, and I look forward to what the future holds for me in the coaching capacity.